Hey, I'm Brian Fisher from Luit, and I'm going to be walking through the Connect 6's powerful onboard DSP effects and show you how to get the most out of them using Control Center. First, we're going to look at Auto Setup, a tool that can automatically set your preamp gain and suggest a processing chain for you. But then we'll also be looking at each plugin individually and how to use the controls manually to enhance your audio. So let's jump in. Auto Setup is a really powerful tool that can help speed up your workflow, whether you're experienced or brand new to recording. It'll walk you through a series of prompts so that it can set your preamp gain and suggest a processing chain that's going to work for your application. This can be useful even if you're experienced because it's a big time saver. All right, so to get started, let's click Auto Setup, and the first prompt is gonna be, what did you connect? So in this case, I have a condenser microphone, the Luit LCT540S, so I'm gonna click Condenser, and then it's gonna ask, what would you like to do? So this optimizes the processing for the activity. So in this case, I'm just talking, so I'll click that. Next, it asks, are you live or recording? If you click live, you're going to get more processing because it assumes that you're doing a live stream or something like that. So it's going to optimize your noise floor, your dynamic range, and make it sound great for a live broadcast. Whereas recording is going to assume that you're going to be mixing later. So it's going to do a lot less processing wise. Let's click live for this example. Now let's do a quick sound check. Testing 1, 2, 3. All right, now it's going to test the ambient noise of our environment. So I'm gonna click start measure and then just be silent. Now we have our setup. You can see that it made sure phantom power was turned on. It included a high pass filter to get rid of any low rumble below the audible range of my voice, set my gain, and added some noise reduction with an expander and a compressor to control the dynamic range. Now I just click finish setup and we're good to go. So now let's dive into each of the plugins individually. And first we're gonna start with the expander. So the main role of an expander is to help reduce noise. If you have background noise like a fan or cars driving by, or maybe the low hum of a refrigerator, the expander can help turn down that noise while keeping your signal loud and clear. It basically expands your dynamic range using downward expansion. It's kind of the opposite of a compressor. This kind of noise reduction is similar to using a noise gate, but a noise gate is more extreme in its settings, whereas an expander sounds a little bit more natural. Okay, so let's do a quick overview of the controls. So the threshold is the point at which your noise is going to get turned down. So you want to set it in a place where the noise level is below the threshold, but the signal that you want to capture reaches above it. The next control is the ratio. This determines how extreme the effect is. So you can go all the way to infinite, which is essentially a noise gate. So it kind of works inverse of a compression ratio. So if a signal drops 1 dB below the threshold and you have a 1:2 ratio, then that signal will get turned down 2 dB. When you have an infinite ratio, it immediately drops off to whatever the maximum reduction setting is, which can sound pretty extreme. So doing a different kind of less extreme ratio can make it sound a little bit more natural. You also have attack and release controls, which determine how quickly the signal gets turned down and then turned back up to normal level. All right, and to demonstrate these controls, I'm gonna turn on some white noise. And now I'm gonna turn on the expander. So you can hear it's immediately attenuated. As soon as I stop talking, the signal gets turned down, and so you hear a lot less of the white noise. If I raise the threshold up higher, you get even more attenuation, but if I bring it low, it doesn't get turned down nearly as much. With the ratio, if I go all the way to infinite, now it's just a noise gate, and so we'll get the maximum reduction every time that I stop talking and the signal goes below the threshold. You determine your maximum reduction with this knob over here. So if we wanted to be pretty extreme with it, we could go all the way to 60 dB. The attack and release times can affect how natural it sounds. If your attack is too slow, sometimes you can hear the white noise trailing off after I stop talking. And with the release time, if I slow that too much, sometimes it'll cut off the beginnings of my words. So you have plenty of controls to make sure that it's as transparent as possible. All right, the next plugin we're gonna look at is the compressor. So the main role of a compressor is to keep your volume level consistent. In dialogue, often people talk louder when they get excited and maybe more quiet when there's a more, you know, calm section or a more dramatic section of dialogue. And this variation can become really challenging for a listener to follow without constantly turning it up and down. If you're listening to a podcast, you might have experienced that. And it can be problematic in sung vocals and in instruments as well. You want to make sure that every word and syllable is heard above the background music for a sung vocal, so compression can help with that. Or maybe you just want to even out peaks of your guitar to make sure that it doesn't get a little overbearingly loud during certain notes of your guitar solo. So a compressor is great for that. So now let's talk about the different controls. So the first control is the threshold. So you can see as I lower the threshold, I get more gain reduction. So the gain reduction is represented by this orange line up here, and this green waveform is your signal. So if I raise the threshold above my green waveform, now we're not getting any compression. So the threshold determines when the attenuation starts happening, when the signal starts getting turned down. So usually I like to aim for 2 to 3 dB of gain reduction for dialogue. If you start to turn it down really low, it can start to sound a little bit overprocessed. All right, the next control is the ratio. So the ratio basically determines how much that signal is being attenuated when it crosses the threshold. For example, if your voice goes over the threshold by 4 dB, it's actually only going to increase by 1 dB over that threshold at a 4-to-1 ratio. All right, the next control is attack time, which determines how quickly the compression takes place. So a really fast attack time, if we go all the way down to 0, is going to mean it'll take place instantaneously, whereas 10 milliseconds or 13 milliseconds, it's going to take place 13 milliseconds after it crosses the threshold. This gives you a little bit of a different result. Sometimes slower attack times can sound a little bit more natural when you're getting some of the initial peak of the audio kind of let through, but you're still controlling the overall dynamics. And then you have release time, which determines how quickly your signal returns to its normal volume level. So a fast release time is going to make sure that your signal returns to normal level as fast as possible after your voice falls back below the threshold. This can sound unnatural if it's too fast, but if it's too slow, then it might not recover by the time your next word comes around or the next peak in your audio signal. So you usually want to find a place where it has just enough time to recover before the next peak in your audio. For dialogue or sung vocals, usually between 50 and 100 milliseconds is a good place to start. The last control is makeup gain. So as I lower the threshold and get more compression, my overall level sounds quieter. So I can use makeup gain to compensate for that and turn my signal back up again. And next, we're going to look at the equalizer. An equalizer basically allows you to change the tone of your audio. You can think of it like a car stereo EQ that has a bass, mid, and treble control. This is just like that, but a little bit more advanced. So Connect 6 has a 4-band EQ built in, and you have a bunch of different controls to boost or cut certain frequencies. So let's talk about all the controls. So the first thing you'll want to pay attention to is the band mode. So if I go to the first band and go to this menu, I can choose a bunch of different shapes. I can do a low cut filter to cut out low end information below a certain frequency point. This is actually something I'll do pretty often with spoken or sung vocals to cut out any low frequency information below the audible range of the voice. You also have a low shelf, so you can more broadly boost or attenuate the low end information or the bass. And then you have peak mode, which allows you to target a specific frequency area and either boost or cut. If you want to make that more narrow or wide, you can adjust what's called the Q factor by holding command and dragging up to narrow and dragging down to make it more broad. You also have settings like notch, which allows you to cut really harsh resonant frequencies. It's a little bit more of an extreme mode for cutting. And then high shelf and high cut, which are useful for the top band. So we have a high shelf over here. So a common way that I might EQ vocals is to set a high pass filter to filter out all the low end below my singing range or speaking range. And then I might even do just a slight boost to kind of the upper mid range just to emphasize intelligibility in my voice. Of course, this completely depends on the microphone and the sound, but this might be a common way to subtly enhance your vocal recording. You also have a gain compensation knob over here, which is really helpful if you're doing a lot of boosting or cutting, which could affect the overall level of the signal. In addition to these EQ bands, you also have a low cut filter over here, so you can quickly filter out everything below 80 Hertz. Okay, and the last effect I want to talk about is the maximizer. If you're live streaming and your audio output in general is not loud enough, a maximizer can help. It makes sure that your audio output is loud and clear without distortion. So both mix A and B have a maximizer. To get more volume out of your mix, all you need to do is turn up this dial. This green signal here represents the volume of your mix. Eventually, when you keep turning it up, you'll hit a ceiling, at which point you'll see this orange line start to take effect. This is where I'm getting gain reduction, where the signal exceeds that ceiling and has to be turned down to avoid distortion. In order to set it properly, you want to turn this up until the point at which you start to see the gain reduction take effect. It should only be taking effect at the very loudest points of your audio signal and not constantly. Thank you so much for watching this video. We hope you got something out of it. And if you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to stay posted on future content like this. And let us know down in the comments if you have any questions. Make yourself heard.